Am I on?
Yeah.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jim, the realtor. We're talking about what happens when you're fresh on the market and you get an offer that's less than list price. What do you do? Well, I can tell you this. From my experience recently, the buyers feel a lot more powerful. They don't feel any pressure from rising prices because it's been flat. And they're happy to wait to buy the right house at the right price. So I got three different guidelines that I'm using to try and judge how to react. If you have a great looking house, one of the premium products on the market, you have a lot more power as a seller. If you have one that's a regular house, everyone's got a nice house. Let's say you know it's got a couple of defects or something buyers are going to complain about. Those are the ones that you might want to either sign that first offer that comes in or make a deal pretty close to that, because it's the inferior properties that are having the most trouble selling. And if you're kind of in that category, don't think there's going to be two in the bush. There might not. People who have only owned their house for 3 to 5 years, which there's a lot of people on the market currently who bought their house recently. First guy that walked into open house today said it. Oh yeah, I saw what she paid. People know. It's all over the place. Zillow and elsewhere now reporting, making it easy for buyers to know. And if you just bought your house 2 or 3 years ago and there's a big gap between that and what you're asking now, you might just want to make a deal with the first guy that walks in, because other people are going to hold that against you. The most motivated buyers are the first ones in. The other one I had, if you have other terms that are more important to you, you might want to also make a deal with that first guy, because if you got a need for a long escrow, or you need a rent back, or you have other things that are going to compound the ability to make a deal, get those and work with somebody who offers early on, and they might be a little more flexible as long as they can get it for their price. So three different criteria I'm using just to try to gauge how bad we need to make a deal with the first guy. If you got a premium property, don't need to sell, and you're not giving it away, let's hold out. I've got no problem with that. We'll keep having buyers be interested in yours. If there's if you just have a regular kind of house and there's a lot of others around you for sale, that's a problem. Or you really want to get moving and someone makes an offer early, try to make a deal. And don't think there's going to be two in the bush. I'm Jim the Realtor.